So magandang araw mga kapamilya. Welcome to our Journeys of Hope Holy Week special. No? So we will have three episodes for this Holy Week, and we'd like to welcome as our special guest this Holy Week, Katie Estrada. Katie, welcome.
Thank you, Father. Hello, everybody. Hello.
Okay, so Katie, so I just want you to share your journey mo, a journey of hope, journey of faith, and journey of love. No? So we just want to ask you to share that with our Kapamilyas in Journeys of Hope. No? So go
Okay,
ahead,
po.
KD. Okay, so
Yes, po.
where do you want to start?
kayo po, Father, whatever you ask me po, I'll answer naman.
Oh, sige, sige. Okay, KD, so maybe you want to parang refresh their memories about how you ended up joining PBB.
Yeah, yes po. I believe, yeah, pandemic po noon at the time, and I wasn't doing anything, and ayun po, I dropped out of my classes. So as in, I was totally doing nothing, and mga online classes ko po, it really burned me out. And the opportunity came for a different life, which was PBB, and it really scared me at first because I wasn't comfortable at all. As in, I believe during the pandemic, I lost all of my social skills po talaga.
I remember that.
I was a very high energy individual before the pandemic, and then it just took a toll on my mental health and on my social life. And
yeah,
I wasn't
maybe
talking
just
to anyone.
Also, let them recall KJ. But you're already singing, di ba? You're already appearing in ASAP, di ba? Kumakanta-kanta ka na noon, di ba?
Yeah, I was po.
Yeah, go ahead, please. Sorry for interrupting, but go ahead. Go ahead. Yeah. So it took a
toll. Yeah, sige lang po.
And then,
yeah, so,
nose dive.
Bali po, yeah, oh po, nosedive. Bali, nosedive po into PBB, which is a completely different life kasi I had no social skills. I was deep in my depression, pero I took it anyway because I saw it as an opportunity to get out of my shell, get out of my my comfort zone, which was just the home, and to possibly change, turn my life around 180.
Yeah.
Ayan po.
Okay, so how did the experience inside the PBB house help you overcome? I remember we, how many times did we talk before you entered? Twice, ano? Twice tayo na.
Twice, twice po. Yeah, we
twice,
talked twice po during the quarantine po. We talked twice through Zoom only.
Yeah. So what turned around? No, what were the important experiences inside the house that without revealing, no, the secret of Kuya? What were the turnaround moments for you, KD?
I guess for me po, I guess this was growing up. I think PBB will really help you mature in a way. For me, it was just learning about other people's mental health stuff, and also ayun po, socializing din a bit, I guess. Socializing again, and ayun, actually it was more of, for me, get away from the social media and like from yung phone. Kasi parang detoxification din po yan, kasi I was very addicted to my phone pre-PBB.
Kate, if I remember correctly, I hope you don't mind my sharing, social media also contributed to your depression, di ba?
So, oh boy, yeah, it's a lot of negativity, a lot of so much content to consume, and the content that I was consuming was quite negative. Nakikita ko lahat puro bad news or puro hate or puro just nothing good at all. And ewan ko, I think this also happens with other people. Like, kahit gaano ka masama yung mga tinitignan mo, they can't seem to keep scroll. They can't seem to stop scrolling because parang they just get into a deeper rabbit hole of what they're reading. And they can't stop because no matter how bad it is, it's still content that your brain consumes and your brain likes that.
It's almost addictive, diba?
Yeah, it's almost addictive. Oh, it's almost addictive po, no matter how bad it is.
And if I may add, Katie, no, I think, and it's also a word of caution. And no matter what your age, hindi lang totoo for young people, no? But
oh,
even older people. Like ako, sometimes I catch myself. Diba, sometimes you just want to check something. Diba, you want to check a message that was sent to you or a message that you saw. But before you know it, you're scrolling all over the place. Diba?
Oh, yeah. You're just scrolling through random stuff and you
yeah. and
forget that
all,
time passes. Oh,
so you discover that you wasted so much time doing nothing.
Yeah, wasted so much time. Oh, oh, oh.
Kids, let me just highlight two important points that I think that you mentioned. No? What that experience of PBB, or maybe three, actually. Number one, it took you out the depression that the pandemic caused. No? It helped you break
Opo.
away from the pandemic isolation. Sabi mo nga, di ba?
Opo,
Number
opo.
Two, it gave you a break from social media. No?
Yeah, it did.
And then number three, I think, and you might want to comment on this. I think part of the blessing of being in PBB and hearing the other stories was that you realize you're not alone.
Not alone.
So,
yeah and yeah of course I not alone because I met of course some of the people that I know, like I know that will stay in my life, like Alexa po.
Yeah, and I remember
we went through similar stuff. Oh, yeah, we went through similar stuff.
Remember when we had that post PBB conversation with you, Journeys of Hope, with you and Alexa, diba? That was one of the blessings you really are so grateful for, that you help each other heal, diba? Tama, diba?
Yeah, we did. We were very supportive towards each other.
Yeah. Okay, go ahead. Sorry for interrupting. Go ahead with your story.
No, it's okay, brother. I know. I guess also having that, I believe having that, you know, that person you can open up to, you can also share your stuff with, your mga very personal stuff. It's very essential din to like helping you grow as a person and helping your mental state, because sometimes you just need somebody to talk to, and you need someone to listen, who will listen with no judgment, who will also give you advice din po.
And knowing that, you know, I always say dalawang bagay importante. Yeah, to have someone to talk to that you trust, diba? That
yes.
And I think part of the trust is built on the part on the fact that, one, you mentioned it, you will not be judged. And number
yes.
Two, hindi ka machichismis, diba?
Hindi ka machichismis. Yeah.
That person will value, no? Will value what you share, diba?
Yes.
No, so,
yes. It, yeah, it's I think for me then, like I keep so many secrets, eh. Because I really do, for me as a person, I value privacy, and I value secrecy of things that people tell me. Like my brother will tell me stuff that I will not share to my parents. My parents will share me stuff that I will not tell my brothers, because that's something it's something very valuable.
Yeah.
And that person, I feel very honored to be trusted.
Correct. Oh,
yeah.
And you don't want to break the trust, diba?
Yeah, you don't want to break any trust.
Trust, yeah. You know, talking about trust, no, and I just want to share this with you because I value it. And I value it a lot, no, also, because it's very, it's very central to my work and ministry. For me not to talk about things that, you know, of course, the sacrament of confession, for example, diba? Yon, number one yon. You cannot break the secrecy of confession. Pero, alam mo, biyaya siya, it's a grace. Eh? Kasi, so people confess to me, no? And sometimes you hear really some of the most challenging and difficult parts of their life, no? But you know, the thing is, kids, no, I don't even have any temptation to tell anybody or to spill the beans or to speak. Wala eh. Wala. Walang, that's why for me, it's a grace eh. Kasi wala akong difficulty to keep it quiet, the confidentiality.
Oh, yes.
And for me, it's you know, it's very important kasi sa amin ano eh, that's the heart and core of my work ano, that I don't break the trust.
Oh, man.
I don't know if you remember ano, I don't know if you remember Rico Yan, the actor.
Yes, we go yan.
Yeah,
Yes, I
you know,
know.
that was when ano, and that is surprisingly, you know, it's really Rico died on a Good Friday, Holy Week yun eh, of 2002. So that's what,
Yes, po.
you
Yes, po.
remember that one?
I was born 2002, pero I was told about it naman po.
You know about that, but no? And it's interesting that he died on a First Friday, March 29, and it's First Friday, March 29 this year, no? But I
Oh,
remember
po.
Rico telling me, and really ito, parang bumaon sa isipan ko to. Sabi niya sa akin, alam mo, Father, ano, I'm very comfortable talking to you because I know you will not judge me. One, and two, sabi niya, I know hindi lalabas yung pinag-usapan natin. And to this day, I have no temptation, I have no inclination to tell people what Rico told me. And even if people
Opo.
ask me, no, oh, ano ba, ano ba, ano ba, I always give, hindi man generic answer, but I give an answer that will not betray the confidentiality of our conversation, no?
Of course,
Even
of
to this
course.
day,
Yes.
even to this day, 22 years later, I have no desire or temptation to
Opo.
hear what we
Yes. Yeah.
talked about. No, but I see what you mean, di ba? And di ba, yun, Kate, yun, it's very liberating. It's very liberating and very healing. Very healing, no?
Yes, very healing.
Yeah.
Healing.
Yeah. And then, now, ano, how are things now with you, no? Kasi, I know this sounds very cliché-ish, but you've come a long way, KD. You've come a long way.
Thank you, brother.
Yeah.
I guess now, I feel like I'm at my happiest, and yes, I do believe that I'm at my happiest now, po. Because like recently, I've been working out. Consistently for a year na po, which I've never done before.
Yeah.
I recently learned how to do adult, yung mga adulting, small adulting things lang po, like going to the bank, learning how to drive. I finally have my driver's license po, so I can fetch my brother from school and stuff. And ayun, in terms of work, I'm just constantly learning about things. I am doing all my research, and if ever whatever role or whatever project comes to me po, I'll be utmost prepared po, because I know that I will, I know that I'll do my best po, and I'll really work for it.
Yeah, but you know, you've stayed in music. You've kasi that was your primary ano before, di ba? Entertainment ano.
Yes po.
Really,
Yes, that was my ano.
you're a singer,
Yes.
you're a musician. You
Yes
stayed
po.
with that, no? Despite the acting and all that. So.
Yes po, yes. For me naman po, actually, I've yung me being into music stemmed from me not being into anything else except that. Pero ngayon po, I think I've developed more hobbies po that I've medyo hindi naman nabitawan, pero I've kind of not yeah a bit I've stopped a bit, but I'm still going back to it po. I'm still going back to it. I still play my guitar, I still sing. But it doesn't make me any less happy, because I have so much going on in my life right now that sometimes I forget to play guitar. But yeah, I'm very happy. I'm very happy that I'm busy in my
The
personal
horizon
life.
is bigger, no? The horizon is bigger.
Yeah, the horizon is bigger lang po. Hindi na po siya limited to guitar and then the phone and then guitar and then phone. It's more of my whole life is expanding na
There's
po.
a lot of new learning, no? A lot of
Yeah, a
new.
lot of new learnings. A lot of new learnings na po.
So, Cage and all, looking back, what would you say are the two greatest blessings in terms of your growth in faith? And how your hope also has strengthened. And then we'll save the best for last. We'll talk about love at the end. But now,
Okay.
how can you, what are you grateful for, no, in terms of your journey and your growth in your faith? And this is just faith in God, but faith in life, faith in yourself,
Yes, yes.
in other people. What would be your, how would you summarize, di ba, that central growth and blessing with regard to your faith?
Yeah. Opo. I would say na I think for me, my circle is keeping my faith. Yeah, sorry. my camera's shaking a bit. So yeah, my family and my close friends keep my faith very, very strong because I believe that they're my foundation po talaga. Sila po talaga yung support ng support sa akin. And we would always have these talks about our family and yung mga private talks lang po. Sometimes we would just get together, we would eat, and we wouldn't talk about anything in particular, pero every time na nakikita ko sila, we're all happy, we're all laughing and stuff. It really shows me how God really made this family for me, and grabe talaga yung support nila sa akin, and I love them very much for that.
Wow, great, galing. Oh. What hope?
Hope. In terms of hope, I think just the support from my yung fandom po namin ni Alexa, yeah, and of course our solid fans. They really give me so much hope because of the things they do for us. And the things they do for me, they're very supportive. They're always there to back us up. They're always there to back me up. And it just gives me hope na there's so much more for me in this business and there's so much more for me in the future and in the long run.
Yeah. And kids, just talking about there's so much more in this for you. And it's just not the the adulation and the kilig of having fans, diba, screaming when they see you.
Yeah, it's not just the kilig. It's not just that po. It's more
the hope of a meaningful career.
Yeah, yung community na nabuo nila dahil sa amin. It's just it gives me hope that I can do good and I can keep being a good influence po to other people.
Yeah, no, nice. Yeah, so now we go to the most important your growth in your journey of love, diba? So, and then later on, I'll say something about my observation during the prom, during the star magic.
Okay, Bo Father.
No, but you want me to say that first, or you want to share first about your own?
I can share naman first.
So, I'll make a comment lang, or share an observation, maybe. It's a better way. Okay. Yeah.
Ako naman, I think for me, in terms of love, I think it's love is not just romantic, boy. Love is for me. I think love is a choice. Love is a commitment to love is a commitment into doing what's best for your loved ones and also for your if you have a significant other, po. Mm-hmm. And I think for me, my love language is very I do acts of service. So I love I love making things convenient for the people I love. And Alexa, I love always supporting her, helping her in things. Like, kunwari yung nasasaktan na yung, masakit na yung paa niya, I would get slippers for her, ganyan. Or I would buy food for her if she feels hungry. Just the little things. Because they really add up in the long, they add up in the long run.
If I may, and can I add two things, no? Number one, I think there's one thing also that I've seen over the last 2 years, na ba? 2 years na yung ano?
2 years na po, 2 years.
2 years na, bilis, ano? Over the last 2 years, you know what I really... Kasi I would see you from time to time, di ba? In mga ABS
events. Yes, Father. Oh.
We don't really see each other. Remember, we promised to see each other regularly, but that is not
happening. Oo nga po eh, pero hindi
natutuloy. We will try. We will try again. But you know, every time I see you, alam yung feeling ko, KD, na I'm so happy and grateful because I think you've also discovered to love yourself. I think, no?
Yeah, loving myself then.
And I can see that the way your transformation took place, no, the last 2 years. Kitang-kita mo yung, and you know, it's a confidence that is just shining through it as a grace, no? Hindi siya yung confidence na yabang eh. But it's a confidence of parang maaliwalas, alam mo yon, yung maaliwalas.
Yes.
And then second, about love, and I think you said it very, very accurately. Sabi mo nga, you like doing little things for the people that you care for and you love to make it easy for them. Yung observation ka kasi nung prom ng Star Magic. So, I guess Alexa had a gown that had some long train or something.
Yeah, it was very long. It was a very long time.
But I noticed how every time she moved, you would very, very quietly go there, you know, almost like bend on your knees to fix her gown, to make sure it's easy for her to walk. And
alam
mo,
po.
You know, when I was watching that, kasi di ba, every time you needed to go up the stage, di ba?
Yes.
I was watching that and I saw you. And alam mo, hindi yung ano eh, alam mo na hindi ito nagpapalabas. Hindi nagpapalabas to si KD. Kasi it was almost like instantaneous na, okay, I'm gonna do this. I have to do this. No? So, that's what I wanted to mention. No? Na, yun na nga, the very simple acts of concern and care that you showed was, for me, that's a journey of love, no? Kasi, sabi mo nga, di ba, love is a commitment. Love is a choice. Really, you need to make a choice, no? But also, the other thing that I wanted to say is, love, as Ignatius of Loyola said, no? Love is best expressed in deeds, in doing things, no? And I guess most especially
yes.
doing the little things for the people that you love.
Actions po, actions.
Actions, yeah. And actions to make life a little bit better for them. No? Both in little things and big things, diba? So okay, it's any final words, no, to our viewers and listeners. Any final words about encouraging them to always trust the journey, no?
Yes, yes. I would say na hello to all of our viewers right now, mga kapamilya, and of course to our fans and to our supporters. I just want to say thank you so much for helping me in this journey because you guys played a big part. Hindi po man sinasabi sa inyo na, pero you guys are a big part of my life and I'm very thankful for all of you. And ayun po, I would say na just trust the process po talaga. Trust God. Because He will... Sometimes there will be things in your journey that you won't like. And sometimes there will be things in your journey that you will like. But it's always a balance of both. You will always be challenged and you will always be rewarded. So, I think for me naman po, you just have to keep going. Just keep going, whatever life throws at you, whether it be a challenge, whether it be a reward, you just keep going and treat every day as a blessing and always count your blessings.
Yeah. Okay, nice, nicely put. And then maybe one last point for you to share about KD. What are you most grateful for at this point? No? What is the one great grace that you feel that... Let me rephrase that. How would you describe now the quality of your relationship with God and how this has affected the way you also live with your family and with Alexa and all? Sabi mo nga, di ba, your big factor of your life now are your fans, no? So how would you describe the quality of your relationship with God at this point?
With God. Well, to be honest po, well, yes, I'll be honest. I haven't been really going to church recently. Pero I've always wanted to go back. And I think, yeah, this holy week, and of course, I think, yes, this Sunday I'll be going. I really want to find myself in a relationship with God more, like in a deeper relationship with God more.
More personal.
Because I think, yes, more personal po. Because I think that's one of the things that helps you discover yourself, help you accept yourself for who you are. And yeah. You'll find more things of yourself, like why they are, why you act this way. Because I think you need to seek God and you'll really find some of the answers. Pero, not all the answers will be shown to you again. Yes, of course. Because that's not how life works naman po talaga. Pero, things will be more clear.
Correct. Yeah. And then, siguro, and then let me end also with this, not just to share with you and with our viewers. You know, one of my favorite writers is Father Hans Kuhn. No? Sabi niya,
Opo.
there are three elements in life that's important, eh, parang to live a life that's very fulfilled. Sabi niya, number one is trust. No, to trust other people, to trust yourself, to trust life in general. And then he said, ultimately, to trust God. No, he said, number one. Number two,
Opo.
he said, it's joy. Our life, kasi sabi niya, our faith must give us joy. It is a faith of joy, no? Resurrection, eh, di ba? The joy of the resurrection. And then number three is meaning, a sense of meaning, yung binabanggit mo nga, di ba, and purpose, no? Siguro what I can say, KD, is that part of our closing is that I'm glad you shared that. Very, sabi mo nga, di ba, na to be honest, I haven't been going to church, but I want to seek a deeper relationship with God, no? I'm
Yes,
glad you shared that, and I'm glad, I'm sure people would benefit a lot from that, no? But I think what you said, the point where you are now, walang accident sa plano ng Diyos, KD. I think
yes, no accident. There are no accidents.
Diba? You're ready with this now because your life is so full of gratitude. And I think there is no better way to renew your relationship with God than expressing gratitude to God. No? Doon magsisimula ulit
yes.
Pagkilala mo sa Kanya. No? Any final words?
Yes,
we'll wrap up. I'll give you the last word.
Yeah, okay po. So to our Kapamilya, thank you so much for watching Journeys of Hope. Of course, to our sweethearts and to our solids, thank you guys so much. I cannot thank you guys enough. I love you all. Hope you guys have a great Holy Week. And wherever you guys are going, I'm praying that you will stay safe and cause no trouble, of course.
KD, maraming salamat. Thank you very much for your time and hope to see you soon. And sa mga kapamilya, again, thank you very much for joining us and have a blessed and a prayerful and also a relaxing Holy Week. Maraming salamat po. This is Journeys of Hope.
Maraming salamat.
Thank you.
I can't feed 5,000, but I can feed one. I can't walk in water, but I can walk in the shoes of another. I can't turn water into wine, but I can turn a frown into a smile.
I can't be there for all the people in need, but I can be the answer to someone's prayer by sharing at least 500 pesos every year to Alay Kapwa.
Sharing what I have in my hands is the miracle that needs to be seen today. This is what I can share. This is my Alay Kapwa. Alay Kapwa, a flagship program of Caritas Philippines by the Catholic Bishops' Conference of the Philippines.